Welcome to the DevExpress Learn Now series, quick tutorials to help you get started using DevExpress controls. One of the latest additions in the DExperience 12.1 release is the ability to show a master detail hierarchy within our WPF grid. In this video, we'll go over the steps on how to set this up. The grid will display data from the categories and products table of the standard Northwind database installed into SQL Express. So let's get started. We'll start by creating a new project and choosing the DExperience WPF application from the startup menu. The project wizard opens. Here we'll deselect any unnecessary controls and make sure to select the data grid with table layout. Click Create Project to complete the wizard. Let's remove an unnecessary column from the XAML markup and run the application to see what is present initially. We see a simple grid populated with some test data. Return to Visual Studio and start the Data Source Configuration Wizard by selecting Data, Add New Data Source. We'll choose Database as our data source type and click Next. Select the Entity Data Model and generate it from the database. Specify the connection string to the Northwind database. Here, we'll make note of the automatically generated Entity Data Model name as we'll need it later to specify the grid's data source. Let's select the categories and products tables. These are what we'll use to set up the master detail hierarchy. Click Finish, and we see the Data Model Designer where you notice the product's navigation property connecting two entities. We'll need this property name later when specifying data binding for the detail grid. Now, let's switch to the designer and modify the grid controls properties. First, let's get rid of the test data by resetting the item source property value. Then assign a name to the grid control so we can reference it later in code to assign a new data source. Set the detail descriptor property to data control detail descriptor so that the detail is represented by another grid control. You'll need to initialize the descriptor's data control property as well. Let's also set it to automatically populate the columns. Finally, specify the detailed data connection using the item source path property that should be set to products, the name of the navigation property that was generated when setting up the grid's data source. Switch to code view and write the following line of code within the main window constructor. Note that the Northwind Entities class is initialized. This name was specified as the data model's name when creating the grid's data source. We can now run the application to see the grid control displaying master detail data. Detail data will be represented with a grid control. Now let's add a second detail that will display the same data using a chart control. The two details will be placed within a tabbed container so that end users can easily switch between them. These steps are best done in XAML. Add tab view detail descriptor and its detail descriptor's property tags to code and move the previously created detail grid into it. We'll copy and paste. Then we can review these changes in the properties window. The grid's detail descriptor property is now set to the newly declared tab descriptor, and you can access its child descriptor collection editor. In the Collection Editor window, add another detail, Content Detail Descriptor. This detail type is specially designed to display any custom control within details. Once the second detail has been added, initialize its Content Template property that'll point to a data template with a chart control in it. Review the chart control's code. Make sure that the chart control is bound to data via the product's navigation property, much like the grid control detail. The 2D bar diagram will display unit price values for different products. So, if we run the application now, we'll see how each master row has two details within a tabbed container. The only issue is that tab headers are empty, so we should specify their content. For content detail descriptor, the tab content is specified via the header content property. For detail grids, it's not as straightforward because the tab name also identifies the grid within the group panel, filter panel, and so on. So we'll need to specify the detail view's detail header content property. Once all properties are set, we can run the application and we'll see that our tabs are now filled with the appropriate content. Thanks for watching. Let's see what develops.